Hello. Is it working? Yes. I'm not used to keep a mic in my face. I'm Bogdan, and my colleague there, Julian. We are from geospatial.org, the local chapter of SGO and the organizer for the conference. And also, we work in a small software company, which is called Soft Business Union. And in our presentation today, we wanted to show you some data. Some of you might know about it, the electronic navigational charts, and some ways to use this data in maybe desktop application, web application, and so on. So what we are going to see is about the IENC, the electronic navigational charts, what types of these kind of charts there are, about the coordinate system they are using, about the standards, which are from storing the data, also for representing the data, the use of this kind of maps in ECDIS systems, we will see about them, and some four examples of applications that integrate this kind of data together with the navigation data from live vessel data and so on, radar data. Okay. There are already like 30 years, I guess, since this kind of data is used electronically, since they migrated from the paper chart to electronic navigational charts. And we got in contact with this kind of charts like 10 years ago when we had a project for Constanța Harbor in Romania. And I'd like to show you first some examples. There are really beautiful and with a lot of cartographic rules to show the data, very condensed. Even a night chart, yeah, about the Gulf of Mexico, and some details. This is half of Black Sea. This is like Constanța Harbor. So the acronym from IENC stands for electronic navigation charts, which are basically vector data stored in binary files. And like I said, almost 30 years ago, they standardized this in like an ISO standard for storing this data in a very condensed form, because the actually files, the charts, are usually small files, around 1 megabyte, 2 megabytes. Yeah, they have to send it to the ships for navigations, but with slow update rates because of the communication. Yeah, you have to get back to the port to get a new CD with data and so on, but since then, things have changed. There's now internet and so on. When they arrive in a port, they download the latest charts. There are two types. Yeah, the first types would begin with marine data, and those are the ENCs. And then we have recently inland electronic navigational charts, which is more like an extension of the marine one, which is specific for inland navigation, which is a different provocation because of hazards that rivers running through populated areas and vessels that are transporting risk materials and so on. So this type of charts are more frequently updated, and usually they are free. The marine data, they are produced usually by admiralties, and they charge fees for getting this data. For example, in the United States, they are free. All my testing I've done with data, it was from United States, and really nice charts from there. And also for inland data, for example, all Danube in Europe, all the countries, they have free data with high frequency for updates, because with changing in water level on the river, they are obliged to update this kind of chart. This is an example of an inland. It's from Drobeta Turnu Severin in Romania. About the coordinate system that are used inside the ENCs, okay, we WGS 84 and in decimal degrees. The precisions, they are used in, described in that, in the metadata of this this chart, fractions of decimal degrees. Depths and heights are in meters, with a small change in, for example, in Romania, until some point it's in meters, then it's considered marine Danube, and it's in miles, all the distances. Usually they are in kilometers. About the standard, the organization is the International Hydrographic Organization, that you can visit the websites and they publish updates about the standard, and also they are maintaining the presentation library. It's the files and the lookup tables that are used to represent the data stored in this kind of navigational chart. About the data model, inside one file, there are usually around 30 to 40 layers of data. Yeah, the skin of the Earth and everything what's on Earth, and also on seas. And with almost 190 classes of attributes that are stored inside. But I'll give you an example. This is a aids to navigation. It's an electronic device mounted on a buoy, on, for example, on the sea or on the river. And it's a platform beacon in this case that, for example, has an attribute of type shape, attribute of color, which is the real color of the buoy that you see on the water, and some category information. If it has a light, a light mounted on that for the night navigation, okay, it's symbolized also. And the type of light is flashing, it's permanent, it's to color white, red, and so on. So this kind of attributes are presented in layers. This is, for example, a point layer. Some examples of other layers, I can try to read from the projector. For example, we have a group of metadata layer describing how, when it was updated, the quality of the measurements and so on. And then are specific information layer, for example, anchorage area, so about beacons and buoys, the signalization, about bridges, about some cables that are in the water, or about dams, or kilometers markers on the shoreline, or traffic separations, yeah, with directions, entering the port, exiting the port, and so on. And underwater dangers, for example, and rocks, and so on, that are actually taken in consideration when you're navigating. So the from the point of geometry, there are points, like I gave the example, buoys, marking cardinals, lights. The idea that the file is so small, they are using a chain topology model, which means that one coordinate appears only once in the file. They are reusing it, that coordinate, in other geometries. Yeah, for example, if you have here we have three objects. Yeah, the top bar, a beacon, a cardinal, and a light. Yeah, three layers of information, but they're using the same point to display, and inside the file is stored only once. Okay, lines. Yeah. For example, coastal lines, so roads, railroads, waterways, and so on. Areas, for example, anchorage area and land. Land is a polygon also, so in this kind of file. And like I told you about chain topology model, And it's an example here that the coordinates are reused to in all those four layers that I showed. The S57 being the storage model for the data, the way the information is encoded in the file. S52 represents the standard for displaying this kind of charts. So it's separated. Each standard is updated independently. And the difference and the update that came from paper charts is that with this occasion they can store more and more information, and although you have only one map, this map can change depending on the situation. For example, for the layers, they implement in some kind of decision models when you are rendering them. It is called conditional symbology, and depending on where, at what scale are you watching the chart, some features will be visible, some features won't be visible, not to crowd the display. And for example, temporal information like tidal information also can be stored. So if synchronize the map with the clock, and some things are visible, are above the water, something are under the water, then are dangerous and symbolized different, for example. Yeah, and our conditional symbology, it's from 1 to 2 pages up to, I think, 10 pages of if it's like this, do it like this. And it's quite complicated. And imagine that to render this real time, you have to be quite fast and optimal in displaying. That's why initially the computing capacity 30 years ago was different. And that's why the files are quite small, not to use one time to display the whole ocean, for example. It would be very difficult. The standard goes there up to defining colors, because they recommend for the use of at least 2 color schemes for the, like I showed you, the night mode for the vessel. Imagine that during the night you do not need a display with light in your eyes, because you won't see the objects outside. Yeah, so that's why they define the color schemes with different intensities. And they stand, all objects that are standard, and all the charts look the same. About the symbols that we see in the chart, in representations, they are mostly, for example, defined patterns in this presentation library. For example, we have here sequences of moving a pen up, down, and moving, and also define this symbol you display using this color. It's an encoded code for the what colors you should use, and that's you how you display a pattern, for example, or draw a pattern on with for vector data. Other symbols, I will show them, are using raster files. If you, I don't know if you can see, this is a collection ABC letters. And actually they create a form. And A means a color, B a color, C a color. And then you will have a like a road sign with a blue and a triangle, white triangle, for example, so meaning a directional signal. Here are some examples of this kind of symbols. Those from, I know the pointer works. These are vector with lines with patterns, also those here. These are for information points that you see, describing some areas. And those are the raster symbol that I showed to you. Yeah. And some complex representation examples. So these are the real signs, for example, for inland maps that are on the shoreline. Another example. And now about a little bit about the use of this kind of maps. First use, it will be in electronic chart display and information system that usually are on board of vessels. You just upload the maps and that's it. Connect it with the positioning device. Also with radar data and other system, for example, weathers and so on. About the ECDIS and displaying the information, integrate the position, heading, speed, information about the water level, about the drought of the vessels. And these are with high updates rates, and that must be in real time. We done this 4 times in the last 4 years in 4 different implementations. First, we are using ESRI software. Then we use GDAL to decode these kind of maps. Then we end up creating our own reader for the files, and now we are creating some kind of server that responds to WMS calls and to serve these kind of maps online. For example, creating a cache of data. This is an example of an ECDIS system. It has an information mode. Then when you load the charts and set up the interface and so on. And this is the navigation mode. It's much compact. And you see the ship position here. You have keyboard commands that are quite fast to zoom in, to zoom out, and the heading information, yeah, and other readings from sensors. So this is for on board of ships. Yeah, when we are moving like all the three color schemes, like I told you, when you are day, dusk, morning, and evening, and on night. Also, in the last years, they start with the investment of measurement on rivers to encode also bathymetric data, more complex data, a lot of contour lines. And of course, the charts started to grow in size from 1 megabyte to 5, 6, depending on the cell. This is how you see the other vessels when you are connected with the system, which is called IES, Automatic Identification System. All ships have transponders and communications, and there is a network that sends and receives messages, everyone seeing anyone else. And now I will show you the same software that it's used in the vessel management system, in, for example, controlling the traffic, what's happening in a port, entering, exiting. Here we see what you see as a triangle are all the vessels in the Constanța harbor. And if they are green, they are moving, for example, yellow are standing. And we don't have it, but if it's red, it's carrying dangerous goods, for example. And the same chart with radar data this time. You see the green information and with light green the trail, yeah, the history of the data. When a special case when they are displaying radar data, it must be integrated between some of the layers of the ENC chart. For example, skin of the earth, the land, which is fixed, and the water, it's first rendered, then the radar and the buoys, and for example, the beacons are displayed on top of radar. So the update rate and it's quite fast when you zoom in, and you have to draw a lot of things quite fast. And they are using a lot of picture-in-picture. They have a lot of displays and video cameras also that are pointed to the sea, and they are opening windows monitoring different zones of the port. Replay functionality to, for example, play data from, I don't know, 6 months ago to see how it was the situation in the port. It's another use. I'll go faster because I have no time. It's about monitoring aids to navigation. That what you have seen until now, it was desktop application. Now it's a web application that is using the ENC data, but this time in web. For example, we extracted the data, put it in a Postgres database from the charts to have queries. Yeah, and using a web map and query and get all the attributes. And also created a way to upload charts on the web and generate a cache to display as a layer, a background layer for the application. With rules to display buoys on top of that chart. And this is another example. You extract all the data from the ENCs together with IES data with vessels, and you create a 3D model to monitor, for example, to watch the waterway to see if signalization it's okay, impersonating as a vessel. Yeah, this example of 3D rendering in browser. Okay. That was. If there are any questions, we have 5 minutes. Four. Please. The question, I will repeat, sorry, to repeat the questions to stay on the stream. The question was about the support of S63. Yes, we implemented, we have a producer code. Yeah, you decrypt the files, yes. No, they are with license. The files with S63 encryption, yeah, it's with permit, and the permit it's usually sold for a specific project, for example, for your own vessel or for a VTS. They have different prices. Yeah, it's. What you have seen here, this river data, which is free, yeah. The idea that they created with, for example, on Danube, we have 1,000 kilometers in Romania, and there are areas when the shallow waters is more frequent, and they have to update the charts more frequently to keep two and a half meters for navigation. So they don't use encryption. They want to distribute data as fast as possible, so they don't care about. We haven't tried, but if the question is about vector data. Due to the conditional symbology, it's a little bit different. It could be done, but these charts are quite precise, and I know vector tiles are using simplification of geometries, and you can lose somehow information. I will think about it, but and on a first thought, I think it's not suitable, in my opinion. It's suitable to publish this data as, for example, WTS, a cache layer, yeah, like OpenStreetMap data, and to store data for queries in a Postgres database. This could be more easily. The rendering is quite strict. If you look a little bit on the rendering and on the standard, you will see that it's okay. The data you can extract it and publish as a vector if you want, but not with this kind of symbology.